that violence has a lot to do with certain genes in human beings. Meaning, it is not police, not the law, not morality, not institutions, not values, not education, not social justice. In a word, not we ourselves, but certain genes that should be made responsible for the never-ending violence. A gene called monoamine oxidase A gene has been linked to violent behavior. Low expression of this gene is linked to violent tendencies. The MAOA gene is found on the X chromosome. Females have two X chromosomes and thus inherit two copies of the MAOA gene. Males, on the other hand, have one X chromosome and thus only inherit one copy of the MAOA gene. As a result, females are more likely to inherit at least one form of the high activity or non-violent type of the MAOA gene. Males have a higher chance of inheriting the low activity or violent form because they only inherit one MAOA gene. They are thus more prone to exhibiting violent behavior.
American Morning, the most news in the morning, period. Weekday 6 Eastern.
It is absolutely fascinating because when you think of genes, typically you think of them controlling things like your height, your eye color, maybe even your likelihood of developing heart disease or diabetes. But to the extent that genes might actually predict your psychological behavior is a fertile and fascinating area of research. The way that they did this was they actually followed 20,000 young men between grades 7 through 12 for some time. They did interviews with them. They took their blood. They tried to figure out, was there something that would emerge as a predictor of violent behavior? And in fact, there was. There were three genes, as you mentioned. Call them violence genes, call them bad behavior genes. But what they found was that if people had these genes, they're much more likely to be violent. There were certain triggers as well. Stress, family problems, low popularity, failing in school. To take it a step further, Karen, they sort of predict that about 1% of the population has these genes. 1% of the population has these violence or bad behavior genes, which is fascinating. People who have them are more likely to be violent, they're more likely to be delinquent, more likely to have all these various bad behaviors. Now, just identifying the genes, as you might imagine, is just part of the issue here. The real goal, according to the doctors that we spoke with about this, is to eventually develop treatments to counteract those genes and get rid of violence. Really interesting stuff.
And they also found that there are just things that they can do and things that their families or people around them can do in everyday life to maybe prevent them from acting out as well. Talk about that.
Yeah, so when you talk about genes, you talk about the gene itself, which is sort of your potential to develop something, and then the gene expression, which is the fact that you actually do develop something. They found with one of the genes in particular, if a young man was to have regular family meals, to have family meals every single day, they almost took the risk of expressing that gene to zero. So there was an example of an environmental counteraction. So it is possible to dilute these genes just through some simple behaviors.
Is violence really genetic? What does Islam say about it? Perhaps the answer is jihad, fighting the negative forces within you.
Evil and of a devil as a person is not what it actually is meant to be in Islam. No? It is the thing in ourselves, no? What we are trying to avoid, what is actually right, what we know is right, and when we are doing it wrongly, something within us knows that now we are doing something which is wrong. So it is the inbuilt thing which we all have and all have, no? Because there is one God and there is one creation and there is one human being and they are all the same. So that is why I think the real jihad is against ourselves. We know, we have been told by Quran and by Islam what actually it is we should be following, what is the right path.
Okay, going back to the topic, like we searched on the internet and we came across a lot of websites where there was news about what the scientists now say about your genetic makeup, you know, determining whether you become more violent or less violent. So does Islam, you think, from what you've studied in any place, mention that also, that you're probably born with that inclination, maybe?
Not at all. this what you are saying, it must be an outcome of this idea of Darwin's, no?
Right.
Survival of the fittest, no? Survival. So you have to fight.
Mm-hmm.
You have to fight for your survival. I don't think that is the right thing. I think there is, yes, survive, of course, but not by fighting, but by being better than the other, or by what is called the right path.
लेकिन जब भी कोई इंसान पैदा होता है तो वो फितरत में पैदा होता है अल्लाह के रसूल अलैहिस्सलातु वस्सलाम का ये कौल है कि इंसान जब पैदा होता है तो इंसानी फितरत में पैदा होता है लेकिन बड़ा औकात इंसानी फितरत के अंदर तशद्दुद पाया जाता है यानी वो अपनी पैदाइश के साथ ही एक पुरतशद्दुद कैफियत को लेकर या पुरुष तशद्दुद अपने अंदर खुद ही सलाहियत को लेकर पैदा होता है इस्लाम के हवाले से कहना है कि इंसान को नहीं चाहिए कि वो अपने आप को उसी मिजाज पर चाहे वो ग्रहण क्यों ना हो छोड़ दे बल्कि इस बात पर मायल करता है कि वो अपनी इस्लाह करे और अपने आप को एक नॉर्मल कंडीशन के अंदर लेकर आए कभी ये तशद्दुद जो है मुआशरे की नाइंसाफी और मुआशरे के बुरे सलूक की वजह से इंसान के अंदर पैदा होता है और सबसे पहले ये इंसान के जहन में जन्म लेता है और उस जहन से यानी वो जहनी जो तशद्दुद होता है वो फिजिकल सूरत अख्तियार करता है
As scientists continue to debate, the question of whether violence is genetic is still largely unanswered. Are people predestined to be violent? We don't know. But given a certain environment and a certain genetic predisposition, the risk of violence can increase. However, we're also capable of controlling it. Why is it that a child reacts violently to certain situations but then learns to gain control as he or she grows? So can violence really be justified? Maybe it's time we should analyze ourselves before we start blaming everything on our genes.
Born to be wild. Born to be wild. Looking for adventure.